Hello there. What do we do?
First couple?
All right. Why don't you ladies each time get in the middle here? I think it makes a prettier picture.
Thanks.
It was nice to see you. I'm sorry that I can't be at your convention.
Thanks.
Nice to meet you. Thank you.
Those of us when I was in the team, we always said that. When we meet someone else, we always say that. So it's TV that does it to you. Hello there.
I have a few mementos of the 33rd National Student Convention. In terms of that, our theme is the rainbow flag.
Yes, it is.
Of course, in Baltimore, around the War of 1812 and the beginning of our Star Spangled Banner. And then if you get a little handy in the kitchen, perhaps you'd like to take some.
I was crazy about cookbooks.
All of our favorites in there. And since you do like to go out in the outdoors, we thought we might keep a little sun off your head.
Thank you very much.
And may I say, look at your pants.
But now I have a little something here. It's just a letter for tonight, as long as I couldn't be there, at least a letter for
them. Oh, nice.
Thank you.
And they've all kind of wondering if we could give you a yellow one.
Oh, what?
It's a square dance term, and all square dancers really enjoy it. It's a hug and a kiss.
Hi, Mr. President. Nice to see you.
It's good to see you.
Mr. President,
a button.
Thank you.
And a t-shirt for you and your wife.
Well, thank you very much. We'd be very pleased. Oh, thank you very much. That's very handsome, and I'm very proud to have it. And you know, you and I have got something in common. I got allergies too. You know, I just came from a room here in the White House across the hall that's known as the Roosevelt Room. Teddy Roosevelt. You've heard of Theodore Roosevelt, the Rough Riders. He's a very great athlete and all as a president. Well, he suffered from asthma also and managed to conquer it. Even Rough Rider that he was, I just know that you're going to do the same thing. All right. I have a little something here, too. It's a jar in there and it has the presidential seal engraved on it. But inside the jar, jelly. All right. Now, should we maybe join all this group for a picture?
Oh, that'd be wonderful.
Thank you.
Show the president button says raising more.
than before.
Just put it right here.
Just center it right here.
What do you want?
Why don't you hold it and keep your...
Put yourself out of the way.
Yeah.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Trying to keep it in service, sir. Nice to see you.
John Francis, Colorado.
Al Otter from Indiana.
And you know General Greenleaf back there?
Mr. President, good to see you again.
Second Lieutenant in the Horse Cavalry Reserve, kind of dazzled by all the stars.
Mr. President, we need...
Well, I think those fellows kind of want you to come a little closer.
We thank you for the privilege and honor of visiting with you here today for the purpose of making this presentation. The Action Journalists Association of the United States established the George Washington Freedom Award to promote and recognize and celebrate outstanding contributions to the freedom of this great nation. Our association, Mr. President, chose you as the first recipient of the George Washington Freedom Award. With your permission, sir, I'd like to read the citation. The Action Journalists Association of the United States presents the George Washington Freedom Award to Ronald Reagan, President of the United States of America, in recognition of distinguished service in the cause of freedom. As President of the United States, Mr. Reagan repeatedly has displayed the exceptional leadership qualities and devotion to duty and country, demonstrated by one of the nation's most outstanding militia leaders and presidents, George Washington. President Reagan's determination to strengthen national defense frequently has required extraordinary courage in the face of both domestic and foreign opposition, a strong point he shares with the Freedom Award's namesake. It is with great and humble appreciation that the Action Journalists Association of the United States bestows its highest award on Ronald Reagan, President of the United States of America. Mr. President, it's my pleasure on behalf of my colleagues to present you this award and to express to you our appreciation for the leadership that you have provided in this nation and your support for a strong defense to ensure that America remains a free nation today and for future generations.
Thank you very much. I'm greatly honored. I don't have any words to say how honored I am and how humbled by this tonight.
Just keep up the good work.
Yes, sir.
Just hang in there for that. Bye-bye. We're grateful to you, Mr. President. They really thank you so much. You've come 1,000 miles under your leadership, sir. The Guard and the Reserve.
I think it's interesting to know that for the first time, as the Army expands right now, taking on new responsibilities, the Guard...
In the years of decline in our military, allowed to take place in this last decade, that one of the most significant weaknesses was the lack of a ready reserve. That was a primary target when we came here.
Well, we think that because of your support, the readiness of the National Guard and Reserve components by achieving greater success, but equipment acquisition.
Souvenirs at the office.
Thank you, sir.
CEO.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Well, thank all of you very much.
Thank you. Mr. President, I was at Omaha Beach with you before. I want you to know you were tremendous. You really communicated. You really made we Americans very proud of you there.
Thank you very much. I was a little unsure as to whether I was going to be able to finish or not.
I understood that.
I think we all felt that, and we recognize how you were coming across.
And that young lady had sent me that letter about her father just a short time before we left. And we sort of, I think, our people eased the way to make sure that they were going there. She had promised her father before he died that she would. And I had just sort of had in mind that well, she'd be someplace there in the crowd, and I stood there, and there she was for a second. And it got harder and harder to keep
you did, good.
Yes, you did.
Right.
You did. We also appreciate the unknowns of Vietnam.
Meet with Mr. Dr. Skelton, the President of the United States.
Nice to see you.
and his wife, Mrs. Skelton, and Herbert Pigman, who's the general secretary of the Rotary, and Carl LeMajer, who is the assistant to Dr. Skelton.
Good to see you.
Pleased to be here. Mr. Riggs also. We have our convention in Kansas City as a makeshift. We would like to extend an invitation to come and address for all.
Well, I would like very much to be able to do that. I've found out I can't make promises. There's somebody who tells me what I'm going to be doing every day.
Mr. President, could we get a picture of just you and Dr. Skelton and then...
All right.
And then a picture of you, Mr. President, and Mrs. Skelton.
You get the middle there. It's a pretty good picture there.
Thank you.
Mr. President, maybe if you could have an individual photo with these gentlemen.
All right. Mr. Pigman, there's in for you to see in cufflinks.
And I'm happy to have this for my precinct.
As long as it's Republican.
That's right. That's what it is. Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you.
And Mr. LeMajer.
Hello there. Souvenir, a little souvenir of this room that couldn't get squared.
Station Community College.
Yes, nice to see you.
Chief of people.
Sir.
What is it, Chief of College? Nice to see you.
Judith, the president of the Community College of Philadelphia. Keeps her busy. Yeah, Jim was the editor of our journal, and our journal coming out in the fall, September.
President, we need to post the picture.
So they want to...
Tell us how you like it.
Thank you, sir.
We've got, when I left, I think it was 94.
106.
106.
Over a million students. We had 9.5 million shooters.
These people, when they're talking about all these federal programs to help young people go to college, well, I can understand that, and that's fine. But at the same time, this is a better way. And seeing if you can't find a plan to get everybody to
Harvard. That's true.
We really appreciate your support in California. Friends. Florida Community Colleges. Jim just joined us.
Hello there.
It's nice to meet you too.
Yeah, come in here a little further.
We're the escorts today.
Joe Schemer.
Good to see you.
Of course, you volunteered.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
Nice to see you. Thank you for having our beautiful lady, Mr. President.
Well, now, why don't you and I, and then we'll
bring
the gentleman in and share you with him.
Okay. Mr. President, I have a gift from you on behalf of all the contestants at the Miss Universe pageant, our 82 countries. The girls have all signed this program book, the 1984 Miss Universe program, the souvenir program book, and this is for you. And there's some very interesting things that they've said to you. For instance, right here, this is from Miss Barbados. Thank you for saving our great neighbor, Grenada.
Well,
and I hope you'll enjoy it. There's so many things in there in all different languages. You'll probably have a time figuring it out, but I'm sure.
Send it over to cryptography.
Well, I will. I'm looking forward to that. Not just names, but...
All the girls send their love. Everybody wanted to be here. They really did. And they say, well, tell President Reagan that we hope that he'll visit our country. So
well,
if you have the opportunity, you'll see what they said here. You've got some personal invitations from them.
Well, thank you.
Thank
much.
You.
Thank you. Very kind. And
thank you so much.
He's just got a souvenir of the office here. It's a presidential seal.
Thank you so much. Oh, I appreciate it. I've been really looking forward to this because
we'll join in this mess.
Okay.
I'm not going to be here very long. We're going to have to go back and vote.
Thank you, sir.
Great.
Thank you.
Well, Very thoughtful. I've never seen anyone do anything quite like that before.
They're a very thoughtful bunch, as well as talented and beautiful. But thank you, sir. She's a great honor to our district, and so we were happy to come over.
That's really been a pleasure. I do appreciate the invitation.
There ought to be some beauty to all this hard work.
Thanks, Mr. President.
Okay.
Thank you.
See you soon.
All right.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
See you.
Thank you.
You see those young ladies getting given my thanks.
All right. If you have the opportunity, please be watching on the 9th of July in this Universe pageant. You'll see all those girls who wrote you those little sayings on the frame.
All right.
Okay?
All right.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Goodbye, Mr. President.
Hello, Mr. President.
Hello, Mr. President. How are you?
Hello there. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
How are you?
This is the reason why Mr. Press Photographer's Dinner
was here. That's right.
Yes.
This is just
one fella here. He knows what he's doing.
He's taking a nap.
Come on, Byron. You can wake up a little bit.
I just thought that we'd just give you a few souvenirs here, some pictures of your activities.
Oh, that is funny. We'll see.
Bad influence, I can tell.
That is very funny. Thank you. That's great. But he's just not waking up, is he? You want to?
Same. And if he did, the only thing he'd pay attention to were those cameras.
Right. Wake up and say hello to the president.
He says no.
No.
Okay.
No eyes.
He's wide awake a little while. Usually he's wide awake at 4 o'clock in the morning. I don't know what's wrong. You know, Mark Weinberg gave this to Byron. And my wife said, this is a really, you know, Republican outfit. So
it's my husband starting out right.
Exactly.
Well,
thank you very much. Huh? Yeah, I'm going to.
I should give him some advice, shouldn't I?
Absolutely. Every good director needs a good actor to tell him what to do.
Well, the only thing is, never go against an actor's instinct.
That's right, yeah. It's funny, that's not what they teach you in school. I don't know if you're familiar with that program, American Film Institute. School where you learn directing and cinematography and the whole business.
No, I didn't know about that.
It's only about 10 years old, actually, in L.A., up on Western off of Franklin, and an old Marymount Catholic girls' school or something, which they converted. But anyway, I'll come back and make a feature.
I had to tell you a little director story the other night up at Camp David, some people up there. I finally decided that they deserved the very best, so we ran Bedtime for Bonzo.
Is that right?
Freddie De Cordova directed that.
Did he really?
Yeah. And
you know what he's doing now.
Jim just got so human, you know, and that sometimes, you know, we're doing a scene with a chimp, and Freddie would correct something that was wrong, and he'd say, cut. And he'd come walking into the set, and he'd say, Bonzo, no. He said, I went. And then he'd hit himself on the head, and he'd say, what am I doing? What you did, like Bonzo, you got his trainer, and you told him what the scene called.
And he showed him another piece of food.
Care of it, but he got so human that Freddie would go in there and start to give him directions.
What is he doing now?
He does a tonight show, doesn't he?
He does the
Johnny Carson show.
Oh, I didn't know that.
The head honcho there, next to Johnny Carson.
Been doing it for just years and years.
Yeah.
Oh, well, yeah. Take care of him.
Thank you, Mr. President. Good.
Thank you. All right.
Thank you.
Well, thanks again. All right, great.
Nice to see you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye, guys.
Bye, Dave.